Good afternoon everyone, I am Gaurav Gupta. Today we are going to take each and every question of the exercise 3.2 class 10th chapter 3 from the NCERT mathematics. The whole chapter is based on the three concepts, and the three concepts we already discussed in our previous lecture. What we have discussed, I am going to take a short view for the revision what we have discussed in our previous lectures. We used a representation of a straight lines in general form, algebraically as well as graphically. What's the algebraic form to represent a straight line equation? This is the general representation of a straight line equation, which is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is the general representation of a straight line. You can say it also as a linear polynomial of two variables, because in these variables are two, x and y, and why it is called linear? Because the highest power of both the variables x and y is 1. That's why it is called a linear polynomial of our two variables. This is the general representation of a straight line. And we taken two lines as well as algebraically and graphically. Whenever we plotted these lines on the graph paper, we observe some points. What that points? We see the two lines may be intersect at a point. So whenever you plot two lines and these two lines meet at any points and meet at only a single point, that is called the lines are intersecting lines. So these lines we can call as intersecting lines. Whenever we plot again two lines, we get another view. What's that view is? We got two lines, but they are never intersecting at any points. If we extend it in either direction, it means if you extend that two lines in either direction, the lines never will be meet at any points. That lines are called parallel lines. So we can clearly visible, or you can see easily, that two lines are parallel or intersecting by using graphically. It's very easy to identify, because whenever we plot, we easily find out either these lines are intersecting or these lines are parallel. And third case is very important. That one is coincident lines. What's the nature of coincident lines is? Whenever you plot the lines, whenever you plot a lines on a graph paper and then try to plot another lines on the same graph paper, you will get the same points which are lies on the same line. It means if you plot two algebraic equations, but the points are common and all points lies on a single lines. So after plotting these two lines, we get a single lines. It means that both the lines are overlapping. Actually, what's the meaning of overlapping is, means the lines are proportional. Proportional means, suppose I have a number 2 and you have a number 4. It means our number is proportional, 2 to the 4. Suppose you get 3, but I have 2. What's the relation? There is no relation. If I give an example 6 and I have 2, so I can write 2 into 3, 6. So these are the proportionality. If you get a lines which is proportional to another line, that lines are called coincident lines. We can easily verify or identify by using graphically. It's very easy. Now we have to use the algebraically terms and find out the equations of our lines either are intersecting, parallel or coincident without plotting graphically. So it's an easy method to identify or tell about the lines are intersecting, coincident or parallel. And it's very easy. How we can find out? Please make a look. This is a general representation of a straight line. I am giving two lines, because we have to use a pair of linear equations, because this is the name of the chapter. We have to use a pair of linear equations. That's why I am taking two linear equations. This is the general representation of a linear equation. If I am going to represent a first linear equation, so I am representing A, B, C, these are coefficients. I am representing it by A1, B1 and C1. Then what will be the results? I get here, our first equation is A1x plus B1y plus C1 is equal to 0. This is our first equation. Similarly, we can write the second equation. What's the second equation is? A2x plus B2y plus C2 is equal to 0. This is equation 1, this is equation 2. These two are the linear equation in terms of two variable. And whenever you find two equations and the question put up us to find whether these lines are intersecting, coincident or parallel, how you can find out? You can find out by using its coefficients ratio. I am again saying, you have to find out coefficients ratio. How you find out the coefficients ratio? You have to divide simply A1 divided by A2, B1 divided by B2 and C1 divided by C2. And please make a note, you have to take the sign also. It means here all the coefficients are positive. Similarly here all the coefficients are positive. If the coefficient is negative, then you have to take the sign negative also. Please make a note this point. You have to do what you have to do. You have to find out the ratio. How you can find out? XX. So A1 by A2, YY, B1 by B2 and constant term C1 by C2. If you find out the ratio, then we have to check our three case. What's the three cases? Our first case is, firstly you have to find out either A1 by A2 and B1 by B2 is equal or not equal. If you get A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, then you can write, this is the condition of our two lines are intersecting. Please make a note. Firstly, you have to do check the ratio A1 by A2, B1 and B2. If they are not equal, then you can say that these lines are intersecting lines. I am writing here, these lines are intersecting lines. Now, if the lines are intersecting, it means they cut or meet two lines at a single point. Again, I am repeating, the two lines intersect at a point. So, point gives a solution of the equation. Again, please make a note, if the two lines intersect at only single point, it means point gives us a solution. So, we get only a single solution. That's why I am writing here, we get a one solution. Because the lines are intersecting, we get one solution, and one solution is also called a unique solution. So we get a unique solution. Please make a note, this is again point. If we get, now we have to find out the nature of the system. Nature of the system is very simple. If you get the solution, then the system is consistent. If you not get the solution, it means system is inconsistent. So in this we get a one solution. But we get a solution. That's why we have to write it, the system of the equations are consistent. So systems of the equations are consistent. So again, if you find out the ratio of A1 by A2, B1 by B2 is equal. This is our first case in which these are not equal. But if you find these are equal, then you have to stop and do one more step. You have to check it. Either C1 by C2 are also equal or not. If you find A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 but not equal to C1 by C2. So this is the condition of our lines are parallel. Parallel means two lines. Two lines means only two ratio equal. Please make a note. Lines are parallel. Parallel means two lines. Two lines means what? Two ratios are equal. And what's the ratio? Only first and second. It means A1 by A2 and B1 by B2 equal, but not equal to C1 by C2. So in that case, lines are parallel. So I am writing here, these lines are parallel. And again note, if the lines are parallel, so they never meet at any points. So we did not get any points. If we did not get any points, it means there is no solution. because point gives us a solution. If the lines are parallel, they never intersect any points. So we did not get any points. So it means there is no solution. So there is no solution. And if we did not get any solution, it means the system is inconsistent. Because the definition said, if we get the solution, system is consistent. If we did not get the solution, it means inconsistent. So system is no solution means inconsistent. Now what's the third case is, if we check a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, again we check which is equal to c1 by c2, all the ratios are equals. If the ratios are equal, equal means lines are equal, and if lines are equal means lines are coincident, overlapping, and if we overlap the incidents, then every points are common to both the lines. So every points are common, then how many points on a line? There is infinite points on a line because a line is made up of infinite points. So if the lines are overlapping and a line carrying infinite points, so we get infinite solutions. So in this case, when the two equations means all the ratios are equal, the lines are coincident, and we get infinite solution, and we get solution. It means the system is again consistent. I hope you understanding this concept. It is very easy, and please make a note, because this concept is very very easy, and this concept is applied at most every place whenever you find out in your final exam as well as in your competitive exam. Either you are preparing for yourself NDA or you are preparing for yourself for JEE main or advanced. So please keep it in mind every time, because this concept is related to other topics or other questions also. Please make a note. So to understand this concept, I am going to take question from the exercise 2.3. Before to start the question number 1, I am going to take question number 2, because the concept is totally based and we have to calculate the solution. So it's very easy and to understand the concept by taking this example. That's why I'm going to take question number 2 from the exercise 2.3. So please make a note. On comparing the ratio, it means we have to do comparison of the ratio. Ratio again, please make a note. What is the ratio? Ratio means a1 by a2, b1 by b2, and c1 by c2. It means it's very easy to find out a1 by a2, b1 by b2, and c1 by c2. And find whether the lines are intersecting, parallel, or coincident. It's very very easy. First we have to do, find out the ratio. So first step is, you have to write all the terms on the one side, then you have to take the ratio. In this, all the terms are on one side. So how you get the ratio means you have to take first x coefficients of both the terms. Here the x coefficient is, I am going to take a1 by a2, b1 by b2, and c1 by c2. A1, a2 is coefficients of x, and what is the coefficient of x is here? 5. And what is the coefficient of x is here? 7. What is the coefficient of y is here? Take a sign, negative 4, because in this the sign is positive and there is no need to write the positive sign. But the sign is negative, then you have to write it. That's why I am taking the sign here. Minus 4 divided by here 6. Now what's the sign is here? 8, and here sign is negative 4. We clearly see. Second step is, try to do simplify. It means if the terms are cancel out numerator and denominator, then you have to do first. Suppose if we cut them, 2 raised to the power 2 means if we cut it on the table of 2, 2 2's are 4, 2 3's are 6. What we will get? We get 5 by 7, here minus 2 by 3, and here 8 by 9. And you know, if we sign get negative on the denominator part, then you can write in the numerator part, because negative indicates the sign of the whole term, not a single term. So that's why I am writing here negative. Now please make a look. Either these equations, either these ratio are equal. First we have to check first two ratio. 5 by 7 and this is negative 2 by 3. It means this is positive and this is negative. This is not equal. And again this is 5 by 7 and this is 2 by 3. So it is not equal. It means these are not equal. So there is no need to check other. Because if a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2, there is no need. Because if a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, what's the result is? The lines are intersecting. So result is what? Our result is lines are intersecting. It's very easy. So please make a note first. Our second part is this. You have to take same step. A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2. So here the coefficient of x is here 9 and here the coefficient of x is 18. What's the coefficient of y is 3. What's the coefficient of y is 6. What's the coefficient of x is 12. Oh, constant term. And what's the constant term is here 24. Now if the terms are cancel out, so you have to do cancelling. So it can be cancelled out on the table of 9. 9 ones are 9, 9 twos are 18. It means we get 1 by 2. Now solve this 3 table. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. So we get 1 by 2. Now cut this on the table of 12. 12 ones are 12, 12 twos are 24. It means we get 1 by 2. So please make a look. 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2. It means all are equal. And if all are equal means all lines are equal means overlapping, and what's the result? Overlapping means coincident lines. So please answer is what? Lines are coincidents. It's very easy. Please make a note. So this is our third part. You have to do same step. A1 by A2, B1 by B2 and C1 by C2. What's the coefficient of x is here? 6. And what's the coefficient of x is here? 2. Now here the coefficient is negative 3 because you have to take sign as well as. Here the sign is because no term is specified means 1 and the sign is negative. So that's why we got negative 1. And here we got 10 and here we get 9. Now next step is do cancel out. We can cancel out 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6. It means we get 3 by 1. Here we get negative which cancel out with negative. So we get 3 by 1 and this here we get 10 by 9. What's this is equal, but this is not equal. And if one is equal, it means two pair are equal, and two pair means lines are parallel. So what's our answer is? Lines are parallel. I hope this concept will be clear to you. I'm going to take next question, which is similar to this question. So before to start next question, please make a note. So now I'm going to take question number 3. It's very similar, but in this question the examiner put us to find out the solution of the system is consistent and or inconsistent, and we know, but we have to calculate the ratios. So third question first part is this. First step is we have to write all the terms on the left hand side. So in this we have to take this 5 on the left hand side and we get 3x plus 2y minus 5 is equal to 0. Then we have to make second equation is also the 7 is on the right hand side. We have to take it on the left hand side and it becomes 2x minus 3y and this 7 becomes negative 7 is equal to 0. Step is same.
what we have to calculate? A1 by A2, B1 by B2, and C1 by C2. Now, what's the coefficient of x is here? 3. And what's the coefficient of x is here? 2. What's the coefficient is? 2. And here the coefficient of y is negative 3. Here the coefficient is negative 5. Here the constant term is negative 7.
It's clearly visible. 3 by 2 is 2 by 3. It means these are not equal. So you can write here these are not equal. If A1 by A2 and B1 by A2 first ratio is not equal, it means lines are intersecting. So our lines are intersecting, and what's the solution? Because the lines are intersecting at a point, and we get a point. Point means we get solution, and what's the solution? If we get solution, the system is consistent. So our answer is what? Consistent. This is our final answer. Please make a note. So our second part is this. Again, this term is not in the standard format. We have to take the right hand side term to the left hand side. Now it becomes 2x minus 3y, and this plus 8 becomes minus 8 is equal to 0. Now we have to do the same step here. We have to take this 9 on the left hand side. We get negative 9. Same step. I am going to take A1 by A2, B1 by B2, and C1 by C2. Here, what's the coefficient of x is? 2. And here the coefficient of x is 4. Here the coefficient of y is minus 3. And here the coefficient of y is minus 6. Here the constant term is minus 8. And here the constant term is minus 9. Now, these are cancelled out on the table of 2. If we get 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, we get 1 by 2. If we get cut, negative sign is cancelled out with negative. Now 3 was the 3, 3 to the 6. So we get again 1 by 2. And here negative sign is cancelled out with negative. So we get 8 by 9. So these are equal, but these are not equal. It means 2 are equal, and 2 are equal means lines are parallel. So answer is our what? Lines are parallel. And we did not get any point because they never intersect. So there is no solution. It means no solution. And if we did not get any solution, the system is inconsistent. So our answer is inconsistent. Please make a note. So our next third part is this. Again, this form is not a standard form. We have to make it standard form. So you, what you have to do? You have to take 7 on the left hand side. It becomes 5 by 3 y negative 7 is equal to 0. Same here. We get 9x minus 10 y minus 14 is equal to 0. Next step is what? A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2. What's the coefficient of x is here? Please make a note. Because in this you get a rational term. So try to make other term also a rational term. Then this becomes very easy to solve. Because in this we get a rational terms. So please make it also as a rational terms. So I'm divide by 1, because if we divide any number by 1, we get the same result. So it's very easy to solve. Here again the terms is rational. Now make it also as a rational. Now it's solved. It's very, becomes very easy. Now we have to write 3 by 2 divide by 9 by 1, and same here 5 by 3 divide by, sign is negative, negative 10 by 1. Here sign is negative 7,
divided by negative 14. And we know if that comes in rational form and it gets in denominator, we have to change the terms. So these terms becomes reciprocal. So what we will get? We get 3 by 2 multiply 1 by 9. In this case, we have to do same step, 5 by 3 multiply 1 by 10, and this negative, because the negative indicates the whole terms. Here, negative is cancelled out with negative. We get 7 divided by 14. Now, please solve. It can be cancelled out on the table of 3. 3 1 is 3. 3 3 is 9. Here again, 5 1 is 5. 5 2 is 10. Here again, 7 1 is 7. 7 2 is 14. What we will get? We get here 1 by 3 into 2, 6. So we get 1 by 6. Here minus 1 divided by 3 into 2, 6. Here we get 1 by 2. Please make a note. In this we get 1 by 6. In this get minus 1 by 6. So these terms are not equal because one is positive and one is negative. So it means these are not equal. So if first two ratios are not equal, it means solution is what? I'm writing here, what is unique solution? Unique solution or one solution. And lines are what? Lines are intersectings. And if the lines are intersecting, means we get one point, and one point means system is consistent, because we already know if we get a point, it means system is consistent. That's why I am writing this system is consistent. Please make a note. So our next part is what? 5x minus 3y is equal to 11. So make it proper form, 5x minus 3y minus 11 is equal to 0. Same to have to do, minus 10x plus 6y plus 22 is equal to 0, because here this is 22 is negative. Now we have to do the same step, a1 by a2, b1 by b2, and c1 by c2. Now you have to do 5 divided by minus 10, minus 3 divided by 6, and here negative 11 divided by 22, and these are cancelled out by using table. 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 11 1s are 11, 11 2s are 22. What we will get? We get here 1 by 2 and take negative sign on the numerator part. Again, negative 1 by 2. Here again, negative 1 by 2. It means all are equal. If alls are equal means lines are equal. It means overlapping, and the solution is consistent. So you can write lines are coincident, and solution is what? Infinite number of solutions. And system is what? Because we get solutions, so answer is consistent. So our answer is consistent. Please make a note. Now this one is the fifth part. Now we have to make the same step. Firstly, we have to make the proper form. So we have to take 8 on the left hand side. We get this. Now we have to do same step. 2x plus 3y is minus 12 is equal to 0. Please again, here we get a rational term. So try to make this term also a rational term by dividing by 1. Now we have to do the same step. A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2. What is this? This is here. Coefficient of x is what? 4 by 3. and here the coefficient of x is 2 by 1. Same here, what's the coefficient of y is 2 and what's the coefficient of y is 3. In this we get negative 8 and here we get negative 12. Now I am solving here. Please make a look. Negative is cancelled out with negative. 8 when the, now if we cut it on the table of 4. 4 2 is 8. 4 3 is 12. So what we have to do in this? We have to do reciprocal the term. Here the term is 4 by 3. So it becomes 1 by 2. This is 2 by 3 and this is what? 2 by 3. Now again you can cut 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. So what we will get? We get 2 by 3, 2 by 3. 2 by 3, it means again we get all the ratios are equal, lines are overlapping and systems are consistent because we get infinite solutions. So we get infinite solution because lines are coincident and system is consistent. I hope you like my video. If you really like my video, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes. And if you have any query, you can WhatsApp me on my WhatsApp number is 9671632413. Or you can also mail me by using my mail ID is gauravgaurav6.gupta@gmail.com. So you have to take a screenshot of your problem or take a snap and on you can do WhatsApp on this number or you can do Gmail or please do comment on my YouTube channel. So because every time I read the comments of the every students, so according to their problems, according to your demands, I try to make a next video according to you. So please do subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes and please press the button of like as well as do share it with your friends so everyone gets the benefits of this video. Then we will meet very soon. Thank you for watching my video from start to end.